Okay, so Anthropic has just done a big drop of two new models and a really cool thing called computer use. So in this video, I'm going to go through the basics of what they've dropped, how it's going to affect things, and I'm also going to talk a little bit about this computer use thing and really how it kind of builds on exactly what I was talking about in the last video that I made. So first up, Anthropic has announced two new models. The first one is an upgraded 3.5 Sonnet, and the second one is 3.5 Haiku, which we haven't seen up until this point. We know that there was 3.5 Haiku on the way and supposedly 3.5 Opus, but 3.5 Sonnet has been out for a while, and that not only became Anthropic's best model, but really in many ways, it was the model that people were using for coding, for using for a variety of different tasks. So today we've got this new upgraded 3.5 Sonnet and the new 3.5 Haiku. It sounds like it's coming later this month. So looking at the upgraded 3.5 Sonnet, we can see how this sort of benchmarks. So first off, this is available today, not only on Anthropic, which is really cool, but I know a lot of us use the Anthropic models on either Google Cloud Vertex or on Amazon Bedrock. So apparently the model is available on all three platforms simultaneously today, which is really cool. If we jump in and look at the stats here, we can see that the stats that they're basically comparing the new 3.5 Sonnet to the old 3.5 Sonnet. They've also benchmarked against GPT 4.0, 4.0 Mini, Gemini 1.5 Pro, and Gemini 1.5 Flash in here. And not surprisingly, the new 3.5 Sonnet seems to be doing better on all benchmarks except for one in there where Gemini 1.5 Pro is still beating it. But the other interesting thing here is that all of these are zero-shot benchmarks. And also, a lot of the new testing, the benchmarks that they're putting out really are relating to not only tool use, but agentic coding and agentic tool use in particular. And we can see here we've got quite a substantial bump in the SWE bench verified. I think it's safe to say the previous version of 3.5 Sonnet was everyone's favorite model for things like Cursor and stuff like that, at least up until the OpenAI 01 models came out. But then I think after that, a lot of people are still stuck with the 3.5 Sonnet models. So getting a new 3.5 Sonnet model that's not only much better at coding, but at these agentic benchmarks is going to be really appreciated by a lot of people out there. And so we can look at these benchmarks that have come out. We can see that, okay, on the SWE bench, before they were getting 33.4%, this is now up to 49%. That's a huge jump there. And also for agentic tool use, the tau bench one, they've also gotten a decent boost there. Now, the other model that has been announced today, this one is not available today, but I think is going to be available over the next week or so, is Claude 3.5 Haiku. And as many of you'll know, Haiku was one of my favorite Claude models when it first came out, and my favorite models overall, due to the fact that it was just so quick, so cheap, and yet still very good. So having a new version of Haiku, which they're claiming actually surpasses even Claude 3 Opus on a lot of tasks, is pretty amazing here. So we can see, for example, with the SWE bench score, it's actually new version of Claude 3.5 Haiku is actually scoring higher than the previous version of Sonnet did. So you can imagine that this is an amazing model in itself, and it's probably really only going to be surpassed by the Sonnet version of this model. Now, the one downside of this is that it's not available today. It's going to be available later this month, and that at the start, apparently, it's only going to be text only. So image input will follow, they say. Okay, so this brings us to the third announcement that came out today. And in some ways, this is probably the biggest one. This is not just a better model per se. This is that they've developed an API which will allow you to basically get the Claude models to interact with your computer directly. So rather than use tools as a general sort of like search, a DuckDuckGo search, a Google search, something like that, it will now be able to just go to your browser and run the search itself in here. So this is very similar to what I was talking about in the previous video that I made, Agent S, and the whole idea of having agents that can interact with your computer directly. In fact, they are showing here that You know, one of the data sets that they're benchmarking on is the OS World benchmark, which was used in that paper that I talked about in the last video. And looking at that benchmark, they seem to have done, you know, pretty well in there. You've got to think, though, that using the agent S with this newer model is probably going to do even better now than it did in that paper. So one of the things that people did raise in the last video that I made is that you probably want to be a little bit wary about having an API control your computer totally. You don't want it to be able to do this. And actually, if we come down into their blog post about developing the computer use stuff, we can see that even they mentioned that even while we were recording demonstrations of computer use for today's launch, we encountered some amusing errors. One being that it stopped their recording and they lost all the footage. And the other being that it just decided to go off and start searching photos of Yellowstone National Park. So I do think you're going to want to be a little bit careful about putting the computer use stuff into action. And one of the things that a number of commenters pointed out on the last video is that maybe now you'd want to have a separate computer that was just set up to do this kind of thing. And I can certainly see that that would make sense. Okay, so in their demo videos, they show that basically typing something in that goes to Anthropic and giving it a screenshot of exactly what you're working on will then allow it to basically look at what you're working on and go in and edit it and use it, as you can see in here. So this is basically taken from their demo of how they're basically doing searches. They're adding things to a Google Sheet there. It's doing a vendor search and stuff like that. Now, all this stuff is running pretty safely. If you notice the local host 3000s here, they're not showing it running on real world apps necessarily at the moment. And they seem to be mostly web-based, but this is definitely a step forward. Now you can see that the responses that you get back from this are really things like key commands, moving the mouse to a certain location, clicking left mouse, clicking right mouse, typing something in to that. So it's pretty amazing that this can go through and work out these things already so that it can take action and do various tasks for you in here. Now, my guess is at the start, this is going to be very similar to something like Tesla Autopilot, where your hands are going to be sitting there to watch it and stop it at any point where it does something wrong. And hopefully their system will have a way that you can quickly stop it from doing something that it's not supposed to do, and that actually could be quite nefarious in there. So in one of the other examples, they basically show telling it that you're inviting someone and getting it to actually do some research for you. And again, really what it's doing is doing the move to, doing the click, and then doing typing. And if you think about it, just those few actions, you can really run most apps on this kind of thing. So by the looks of it, they're using a Mac with almost nothing installed in here. And you could imagine that you'd want to be a little bit safe with how you do this. I've still yet to see the API and, you know, how this is actually going to run on your computer. So I think that's going to be an interesting follow-up video. And I'm not sure if I really want to run it on my laptop at the moment. I need to read the docs a little bit before I get into that. Anyway, just summing up. Overall, this looks like a fantastic new release, especially if you're doing things like using models for coding, for that kind of stuff. It sounds like the new 3.5 Sonnet sort of upgraded is going to be fantastic for that use, and that the Claude 3.5 Haiku is going to be really good for sort of speedy agent use, where you can basically just do lots of calls really quickly to something, and then maybe have the larger Sonnet model as your orchestrator. Now, one of the big things that they, of course, haven't announced today is the Opus 3.5. And are we going to see an Opus 3.5? And you could imagine that that's going to be one pretty amazing model based on these models when it eventually comes out. So I'll leave it there for today. If you've got any questions, comments, please put them in the comments below. As always, if you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe. And I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.